Hey guys, sorry for the wait for an update video, but here it is. So I've owned this VR4 for a few months now. Been really enjoying ownership so far. It's been super fun to drive. And I just figured to make a quick video since this I probably won't drive it for a little bit. So just quick update of what I've done to the vehicle. Just mainly exterior stuff that I've done just to kind of make it my own and make it my representation of what I want a VR4 to look like. Just trying to make it as clean as possible. But before we do, let's take a look. So I went ahead and I got those Kanze KNP wheels. I also detailed the car, got it paint corrected, ceramic coated. It came out beautiful. The paint on this car is unreal for being 30 years old. Here are the wheels. They are an 18 by 9. I believe. Yeah, 18 by 9 plus 35 offset. They didn't clear the brakes, so I had to run a really small spacer, but I mean, you can maybe put a credit card in there, which is kind of crazy, but yeah, so I've been really enjoying the car. It's just, I don't know how to explain it. It's not the fastest thing out there. Like I said, it makes around 400, but it drives so smooth and it's so fun, and it's just the way I explain it. It's just pleasant. It's just pleasant to drive, you know, especially on a nice day. I took it out earlier today. It's not too nice now, but it was a little bit nicer earlier. You know, just taking it through the gears, it rides so nice. And yes, I know the fitment, even I like the fitment, it looks like OEM. There was a good bit of wheel gap. It is on teen springs. However, it rides so nice that I don't want to mess with it. You know, this car, it's just different. You know, it was designed to be a GT car from Japan in the 90s. It's not a raw sports car. So, you know, I'm not too worried about the fitment and making it, you know, putting it on coils and making it, you know, more flush or whatnot. I think it looks good. And I don't want to mess with it. Some of you might hate me for that, but I'm just enjoying this thing, man. I didn't expect to enjoy it as much. So as you can see, headlights are redone. Stripped that down, new clear coat. And yeah, so that's pretty much it on the exterior. Like I said, I've just done maintenance, you know, transfer case fluid, transmission fluid, oil change. I'm not messing too much. I'm not doing any performance stuff. Drivability is perfect. It drives good, has good power, and it's just enjoyable. So I'm going to post some before and afters of the paint correction I did on this car and the ceramic coat, so you can see kind of how it was and where it is now. So put that over now.
I'm not afraid to
All right. And as you can see, like I said, it took the car from a good-looking 30-year-old car to just, you know, like just crazy how it turned out. I'm just so glad I poured a lot of time into it. But the paint, like when the sun hits it, I mean, it's hard to see swirls, scratches. It's an incredible shape. So anyways, going on the interior. So I did a few things. So first, Momo Monte Carlo leather with red stitching. So I went with this wheel because I feel like it looks kind of OEM. It's not too aftermarket looking like some of the other wheels. It's just kind of like classy and nice. And the stock wheel was a little worn out. And not only that, but the stock wheel was really bulky, so it just wasn't, it just didn't feel right, in my opinion. So, you know, this wheel is just complements it. It feels really nice, and it doesn't look crazy. I did order a Mitsubishi horn cap. We'll see how that looks. I kind of like how the red looks with the outside and how it matches. Yeah, and then a couple things I've ordered that are not installed yet. I ordered a new leather e-brake handle with like red stitching. I also ordered a new shift boot with red stitching. And I also have an Android Auto Apple CarPlay screen that's gonna go in here. And I think it's gonna look awesome when I'm done with it. Like with all the complements and the steering wheel and the leather pieces. And like I said, the interior is in pretty good shape as well. I'm keeping the seats. They're really comfy. Like I said, I want to stay true to what this car was, you know, aimed to be, which in my opinion is like the ultimate Japanese GT touring car, sports touring car. I'm not trying to make it fast, not trying to, you know, make it 1,000 horsepower. 400 is plenty for this car. You know, I'll buy something else, a better platform to make fast and, you know, enjoy. So, but yeah, that's kind of a quick update. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll make a quick update video when I have those things installed. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. Thanks.